We'd hang out on the weekends and we'd watch movies. So we can't imagine that for such a normal family man that something like this would happen.
This is 53-year-old Australian civilian Hasan Askree.
We call him Hasan Mamu, and he has been with us every step of our life.
He'd worked in the city as a risk analyst for American Express.
He was fused to us. It was always the five of us, the two of us, our parents, and Hasan Mamu. We were always a team in Sydney.
Because he doesn't have, like, an immediate family of his own, we have always been his children.
In 2015, Hasan, a dual national, returned to Pakistan to care for his elderly parents. On the morning of October 2, 2020, there was a knock at the door of the family home in Islamabad.
They barged into our home and just everyone in the family was so traumatized and so confused.
It felt surreal, like it was a movie plot or something like that.
It sounds like he was effectively disappeared.
Yeah.
He was disappeared.
He was completely disappeared.
Hi, Mom.
Ma.
Hello, Jano. How are you?
Zen and Gia's mother, a Sydney high school teacher, has been in Pakistan for more than 2 years, fighting behind the scenes for her brother's freedom.
Actually, we didn't know whether he was alive or dead for months after that because we didn't know where he was. He was just kind of missing.
Hasan, the son of a retired Major General, had, it later turned out, written an extensive letter. It was one of a number he'd sent urging change in Pakistan. This letter, which is still under wraps for legal reasons, was a manifesto of sorts, directed at senior officers in the military, demanding the immediate resignation of the Chief of Army Staff, Qamar Javed Bajwa. Hasan reportedly blamed Qamar for many of the country's problems and accused him of failing to exercise any restraint over the former cricketer turned Prime Minister, Imran Khan. Hasan was detained in secret, then court-martialed, convicted of abetting a mutiny and sentenced to 5 years. His family says the whole process was a sham.
Why haven't they ever given us a copy of the charge sheet? We haven't seen it. They showed him on a plain piece of paper written 5 years imprisonment and with no letterhead, no reference to his case or his charges, nothing. On one simple plain white paper, one sentence typed.
Do you think that in doing this, he knew the danger he was putting himself in?
Yes, I did think he had some idea, but not to the extent which has happened.
Is your uncle capable of overthrowing the Pakistani military?
Absolutely not. Like, this is the sweetest man you can possibly imagine.
It seems Section 131 of the Pakistan Penal Code is what he breached, even if the family may find it hard to fathom.
I think he was trying to make them conscientious to do the right thing for their country.
Even now, this family is cautious about stepping forward publicly.
Tell you the truth, I am still a little bit scared. Scared for my brother's life, scared that they will do something to us because we did not speak all this time because of this fear.
Pakistani human rights lawyer Iman Mazari says the family is right to be worried.
Now that they've broken their silence, the military in Pakistan is known to get antagonistic when people speak about their excesses, so I'm definitely very concerned for their safety as well.
Iman says it's not uncommon in Pakistan for civilians like Hasan to be hauled before a court-martial.
I wouldn't even call it an arrest. I would say it's an abduction from the very date that they took him. This was wrongful confinement and wrongful prosecution.
My brother is in 24-hour solitary confinement. He has no access to sunlight, fresh air. His walls and ceilings are full of fungus that fall on him and the cell is crawling with insects. He says, I spent half my day just killing insects. There have been months and months that they don't even let him write a letter to us. I think, I don't know, what is that punishment?
Hasan received one consular visit from Australian officials soon after he was arrested. Since then, the family has written to the Australian government 7 times asking for help.
Nothing. No communication, it's just me writing or calling. I got an automated response from Honorable Penny Wong, but that's it.
Since Hasan's arrest, Pakistan has gone further downhill. Former Prime Minister Imran Khan says his enemies want him arrested or murdered. He's facing terrorism charges as the showdown with his successor Shahbaz Sharif becomes increasingly violent. Hasan's nemesis, General Kamar, has resigned. But there's no sign of clemency for Hasan himself. And his family is now desperate.
I think we just lost all our hope. We really thought they will communicate with us, talk to us, but nothing happened. My mother keeps saying, if he comes, then I can die in peace. But that's where the fear is, whether they can. I just want him to be free.
Hamish McDonald joins us now. Hamish, what's the response been from the Australian government to this?
Well, I've received information from the Australian government late today suggesting that they have in fact acted upon some of those communications from the family. Representations have been made to the Pakistani authorities up to 20 times, that our High Commissioner there in Islamabad has made personal representations as well. And in what might be a sliver of hope for this desperate family, I understand that within the last few hours, they've received an offer of a meeting with Australian officials in Pakistan. That could happen as early as next week, and clearly that's a significant step for them, but it will still be a much longer journey than that.
What about the response from the Pakistani government?
So we were assured that we'd receive either written or verbal communication from the Pakistani High Commission in Canberra today. I spoke to them as late as just after lunchtime. They told me that the Deputy High Commissioner was going to ring me back with a response. That hasn't happened. That doesn't mean, though, that they're unaware of this. And the questions that we have put to them relate to whether or not they're going to allow Australian officials to go and visit Hasan. It's many hours away from Islamabad. Ultimately, the military's in control of the arrangements around where he's being held. So there's definitely questions for the Pakistani government to answer here. And don't forget that there has been a lot of interaction between both governments over the last 12 months or so because of the floods in Pakistan. Australia initially contributing $2 million, then topping that up with another $3 million, fostering good relations. And in fact, the Pakistani High Commissioner in Canberra has said that rich countries like ours do need to stump up with what he calls climate reparations when things like those floods occur. So there has been dealings at the very highest level between these two governments, and perhaps that might offer some hope again to this family who want to see some movement after so many years now of absolute silence.
No doubt. Hamish, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks, guys.